CoasterForce to ride the new attraction at Thorpe Park, The Swarm, and apparently war has begun. So what's the story? Well, in early 2011, when construction began, stories began surfacing that lies were being told, secrets were being kept, and that something was coming. Then, in the months leading up to the opening of the coaster, short videos began appearing on the internet, which showed people disappearing from their everyday lives, almost as though something had swooped down and abducted them. This something was called the Swarm, and it's some kind of creature hell-bent on destruction, and its latest target is Thorpe Park. The Swarm was known as Project during construction and was completed in March 2012. It has a wonderful height of 127 foot, which is just short of 40 meters, and it has five inversions, one of which Thorpe Park are actually calling the world's first inverted drop. It has a capacity of 28 people and a top speed of around 57 miles an hour. On its very own island of reclaimed land in Manor Lake, which borders the northwest side of the park. Now, the island has given the look and the story of a British village that is currently under an ongoing attack from the Swarm, which is swooping and circling around the area.
And the human race is about to be wiped out by the Thorgs. But apart from that, it's a beautiful day.
Destruction, including a real aeroplane fuselage, a fire truck, all different kind of media vehicles, and if you're really lucky, you might even bump into some of the survivors from the attack. Also nearby, you might spot the military camp that's been set up, ready to take on the Swarm. Everything from the toilets to the sideshow stalls have been themed to match the island. This one, for instance, looks like an upturned lorry. It's been absolutely obliterated. The numbers are good, the story's all in place, but it's about time I gotta go, so I'm going. Gonna join the queue. Actually leads through some of the wreckage on the island up to the apparent sanctuary of a church. However, this is where riders will be abducted by the Swarm. You'll also notice that throughout the queue line there's loads of tension building up because of the emergency broadcast network basically updating everyone about the desperation of the situation we're in. Technically speaking, the Swarm is the latest roller coaster model design from manufacturers B&M, and it's called a wing coaster. Now, it's called a wing coaster because unlike on conventional roller coasters where you sit above or below the track, on this one you sit either side, meaning that there's nothing above you and nothing below you, making your whole experience a lot more exposed. Of course, Thorpe Park have taken great advantage of this exposure by combining it with extensive theming to provide lots and lots of near-miss, death-defying effects. And it is that time where I have to turn you off because I'm personally not allowed to take a camera on to ride. So we'll see you on afterwards. Bye! Just let it slip. His palms are sweaty, arms are heavy. Vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous. But on the surface, he's calm and ready. You drop down. Areas, there's some real good speed going on, and all the elements and the near misses, and there's just just so much going on. It's absolutely brilliant. I absolutely love it. I can't wait to go back on. Okay, so now we've been given a little bit of a CoasterForce exclusive. We're actually being allowed into mission control, otherwise known as the ride operator box. Come in and have a look. So is it like really complicated having to watch two sides at once?
It's very different.
Okay, cool.
We've done a lot of different things on the ride. If you notice, the guys were here to use these radios. Because of the fact there's two sides, you can do so much with the ride, release individual restraints, all that kind of stuff. So we've made everything as easy as we can by giving them earpieces and stuff and making things a lot easier. We kind of stole the idea from Raptor and Gardenland, actually, but it's working really well. But yeah, there's a lot going on down there, there's a lot to kind of focus on. But so far, everything's been going really, really good.
If you watch closely, they're just putting the restraints down now, and then they're going to use those buttons and things to send the train. And does actually just make it look really, really simple, just like that. Really, all that's left to say is thanks for watching. Please get down here and ride the swarm soon.